Today, our house hunters want to get as far away from it all as possible.
Looks fantastic.
This really is more like it.
More like it, more rural?
Much more like it.
We deliver the new and the desired.
Wow. I guarantee this is not what you were probably expecting.
I've always wanted a big bathroom, and maybe it's my time.
Now, if you are looking for a good time in the countryside, I have just the perfect spot for you. Herefordshire, which, amongst many other things, is famous for turning these into this. In fact, one local cider producer makes 120 million pints of the stuff every year. That's 622 pints for everybody who lives in this beautiful county, and it is a beautiful place. But of course, I would say that, wouldn't I? Because I am also one of the lucky few who call this place home.
The average price of a detached home in Herefordshire is about £20,000 less than you'll pay across the rest of England. Pretty good value, I'd say, and I've put my money where my mouth is. But of course, I'm not the only one.
It's a lovely place to live. If you like the open countryside, you've got the River Wye on the doorstep, as well as lots of nature trails and truss. It's definitely the place to come and check out.
Much of the river winds its way along the border between England and Wales, and there's much adventure to be had in its waters. As well as its natural beauty, the county is known for standout architecture, such as the black and white timbered buildings in the market town of Ledbury. Foodies are drawn here to sample fantastic local food and drink, plus producers who want in on the fertile action.
We came to Herefordshire because if you're going to start a cider business, running an orchard in Herefordshire is like running a vineyard in, I don't know, Bordeaux or Napa Valley.
It's just been the support of everyone that's helped us grow, and that's just been wonderful.
So it seems there's something for everyone in my home county, whether you're just visiting or looking to settle.
If someone was thinking about moving to Herefordshire, I would say go for it. We have the best of both worlds here. You can live in a beautiful rural location, but have fantastic connections to the city and a wonderful quality of life.
Now, although the vast majority of Herefordshire's countryside is given over to farming, clearly you don't have to be a farmer to actually live here. But it is worth remembering that 95% of the county is classed as rural. So, as you can see, there is plenty to go around. All of which is great news for today's buyers. 6 years ago, they decided to swap city living for town life, but now want to mix it up even further with a move to the countryside.
I think we can find a lot in Herefordshire that's much harder to find in the southeast. Space both in the house and space outside the house. I think space, countryside and quietness.
Kent-based couple Graham, a business development consultant, and Jennifer, a solicitor, first crossed paths on a night out 12 years ago.
I was at a drinks do. My drinks do ran out of booze partway through the evening, so I went to the main bar, and I noticed Graham was just behind me, also waiting to get to the bar. So I offered to buy him a drink.
I said yes. She gave me her card. Thank you very much. And I called the next day, and we started seeing each other.
Graham must have been smitten right from the start, as he popped the question just 1 month later.
We were travelling into work together on the Central Line, and around Shepherd's Bush, he asked me to marry him. But I did say yes the following day.
And it was a good result. We've been married 11 and something years now, and I think it was a good decision on both parts. Very happy, so far.
During their marriage, they've lived in both London and Kent, but now they want to go really rural.
I know Herefordshire quite well because my parents lived there for quite a long time, and my sister Andy still lives there.
I didn't know Herefordshire at all until I met Jenny. The countryside is beautiful.
It had been in the back of our minds for a long time about one day perhaps living the dream in Herefordshire. It wasn't until lockdown, however, that really gave us the opportunity to think, we can do this. One of the reasons for that is that I found that I could work from home quite easily.
Their current home is a small two-bedroom cottage, which is a bit of a tight squeeze when the four grown-up children they have between them come to stay.
One of the key things we're looking for is space, inside and outside, for friends, for family, for all the things we'd like to do.
Moving to Herefordshire signals one big compromise for Graham. Life in a landlocked county will mean he'll have to say goodbye to his beloved sailing boat. But he and Jennifer have many other interests to keep them busy.
The night sky is fascinating, and I'm interested to learn more about it. And I think in Herefordshire, you've got big skies, you've got clear skies, and you've got very little light pollution, so you can see the sky.
They also want to get involved in nature conservation and just totally immerse themselves in country life.
It'd be great to have the chance to really give it a go and do it for real.
You know, you should always leave a party when it's going really well, not when it's 5 a.m. and everybody's sobbing into their drinks. So I think this is a good time to be leaving Faversham. Whilst we're having fun, we're going the whole hog this time. We've done the halfway house. Now it's time to really jump in feet first and start a rural life.
That's the spirit, Jenny, ready to embrace country life in all of its glory. And having heard about the lifestyle that they crave, I am certain that Herefordshire should more than deliver on those aspirations. What's more, she and Graham seem really focused on the kind of property they're after.
With £700,000 to spend, they're after a bright property with space both inside and out. They'd like a large kitchen diner, at least three bedrooms and a garage or workshop. The location should be quiet and private. The more rural, the better. With their wish list in mind, we've handpicked three great properties to show them. But they'll only find out the price after they've looked around each one and had a stab at guessing it first. The final visit will be to the mystery house, which will challenge how much space they really want. Now, all we've got to do is get together and get started.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to Herefordshire, because this is not a new county to you, is it, Jennifer, really?
It isn't. My family's been here for a few years, and my sister currently lives in Hereford itself.
So you know it reasonably well?
We know Hereford City and some of the environs, but this is a great opportunity for us to explore more of the countryside. We've done a little bit of looking, but haven't really found anything so far.
So the pressure's on then.
Yeah, I think what we've done is we've looked around and we've kind of narrowed it down to this part of the world, really.
Well, I am keen to gauge just how rural you both want to go.
It's a long time since I lived anywhere really rural, and that was only for a short period. Most of my life I've lived in towns and cities. I think I'm ready to give that a try now.
Getting those green roots going. And thank goodness, Jennifer, you got the memo about wearing a gilet. If you've got a gilet on, your house hunting is going to go well. That's
Sounds
my
promising.
Excuse anyway. Right, come on, let's go and have a look.
Okay.
As we launch into our Herefordshire house hunt, we're headed to the Wye Valley and the rural village of Peterstone. There's a quiet and relaxed feel here, but for those wanting to really take it easy, there are over 60 types of cider and perry available at the local, voted Cider Pub of the Year in 2019. Just a mile away on the outskirts of Peterstone and approached by a gravel driveway is the sprawling barn that we've come to see.
Well, our first property of the week. What do you think of this, sir?
Well, this is unexpected.
Nice little barn conversion. Not uncommon in this part of the world, but this lovely ironstone gives it away as very kind of Herefordian. The whole lot converted about 2004. Where are you on barn conversions?
For me, it's a maybe. Some of them look really great, others I'm less sure about. So I'll be really interested to see how this one works inside.
So what would worry you about a barn conversion?
I think it's the idea of it perhaps being long and thin, but also, more importantly, that it may feel like living in a barn.
I don't know how to answer that one, really.
It's a very pretty exterior.
Pretty, isn't it?
It's very pretty. I think you'll find this cosy. I think they've done it really nicely. But let's see if I'm right. Come on, have a look inside.
This handsome barn dates back to the early 1900s, and it sits on a site of around 3/4 acre. I'm hoping that once we're through the front door, any concerns Jennifer has will disappear.
Right, come on in to this lovely, generous hallway into this.
It is really nice, isn't it?
Oh, wow. Lots,
yeah,
of,
really nice.
Lots of space for entertaining family and friends.
And it's got that barn feel.
Yes.
But hopefully not excessively so.
But actually, despite the high ceiling and everything, it doesn't echo. I like this room a lot.
Great kitchen.
And it flows on beautifully through here. Have a look at this. Into yet another really welcoming family space.
Oh, right. Yes. Wow, who would have thought this was here on the end of the dining room?
Absolutely.
Great for parties.
Really nice proportions. It's unusual to see a square room these days.
Great access out to the garden as well.
Yes, I love the double doors there and there. So you've got fantastic access.
Yeah, on two sides.
Makes it really light as well.
So this barn conversion.
A tick.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Excellent, good. Right then, now you have got five bedrooms to view as well. Let's start on the ground floor with one of these. Have a look.
This floor is laid out in an L shape, with the living quarters and kitchen in a single storey wing to one side and two of the bedrooms on the other. Access through a music room comes snug. Both bedrooms down here have en suites, giving great options for guests or indeed for Jennifer and Graham themselves.
I like this one on the ground floor because it's got access out to the garden with en suite through there too, with a little slipper bath in it, which is rather nice. But the choice would be yours.
What fabulous views as well from this double door.
Yeah.
Nice with doors, windows and doors on both sides,
yes.
On two sides.
Yes.
Yeah.
That is good.
There are a load more bedrooms that I've alluded to, which you should explore, I think. So go and have a wander, and I will find you outside in the garden.
Great.
After you.
Okay.
House is yours.
Upstairs, there's a fully tiled family bathroom and three more double bedrooms. One has access to outside, and the largest has an ensuite bathroom.
Uh-huh.
This is a great room.
I like the high ceiling.
This move is an upsize for our buyers, and there's certainly a lot to take in here. The same could be said of the outside, where there's a double carport, a store, an outbuilding ideal for a home office or workshop, and a well-looked-after secluded garden of around half an acre, surrounded by a variety of mature trees. The views look out to the Wye Valley.
Well, guys, what do you think of upstairs?
Really great.
It's very well done.
So that's the property then. Outside, as you can see, quite extensive grounds, which do wrap around it rather nicely.
It's a versatile garden, certainly.
Versatile. Mm. Very good word. OK, so let's move on then to what we think this is on the market for. Graham?
I'm going to say 660, 660.
£660,000, mm. OK.
I'm going to go a little higher than that because of its location to Ross-on-Wye and places. I think 675.
You've actually straddled it.
Have we?
Oh!
It's on the market for £669,000.
Oh.
I think you were slightly closer, but only by
well, you know.
It's a smashing house, and we haven't seen anything like this.
No.
Have you not?
No.
No.
Okay.
Not until now.
So it's left a good impression.
Mm. Yes.
Excellent. Right then, we'll go and have a wander around. Now you know what it's on the market for, and I'll find you a little bit later on.
All right.
Thank you.
Off you go.
Thank you.
Enjoy. Brilliant. Well, it's always very nice to get to the end of our first property tour with a very positive reaction, and that is exactly what we've got here. The right thing, in the right place, at the right price. Excellent.
This early 1900s barn with its more recent conversion is a comfortable £31,000 under budget. It's been refurbished to a very high standard with a large kitchen diner and equally sizeable living room. There are five bedrooms, a lovely garden, plus a great home office, and all of this is at a fantastic location.
Oh, this is a sweet room, a music room.
Useful to have an extra reception room.
Yes. Fantastic first start. I really loved it. And how interesting to see a barn conversion that works so well.
I think we could live in this house quite comfortably. The kitchen is great. You've got a big living room when there's a lot of you, a small living room when there's not so many of you. And the garden is lovely with a nice view over toward the hills. So I could imagine living here quite comfortably.
All done?
Yes.
Thank you.
Happy?
Great.
Nice house.
A really nice house, and I think a good start. And it's certainly given me a few pointers as to what we might be looking for going forward. So, yeah, I'm happy.
So are we.
Want to see another one?
Yes,
absolutely.
Please.
Come on, then.
Herefordshire's countryside is buzzing with wildlife. And when they move here, Jennifer and Graham would love to get involved with helping to protect it. They've come to Bodenham to visit a 110-acre nature reserve. Half of the reserve is taken up by the largest area of open water in the county. But the beautiful site wasn't always like it is today. Many years ago, it was a gravel pit, which filled with water from the water table underground once quarrying ceased. Sophie Cowling is the senior project officer of the award-winning restoration work.
Welcome to the beautiful Bodnam Lake Nature Reserve. Herefordshire Wildlife Trust and New Leaf took over management of the site back in 2016. And we've been doing a project here to make it less of a gravel pit and more like a natural lake.
What's the history of this place?
Up until around 1920, this was all called Lady Close Farm. And then people started extracting the gravel in a very small operation, just using wheelbarrows. And the gravel pits got bigger and bigger then, using large-scale machinery and barges to transport the gravel around. And eventually the gravel pits were connected to form Bodnam Lake, as you see it today. And we've been using diggers to make the edges of the lake nice and shallow and to grow a reed bed. They've moved over 40,000 tonnes of soil. And we've also made these islands here, which we made from an old road, which are perfect for birds to nest on.
Yes,
things like oystercatcher have nested already.
So what exactly is the reed beds and why is that so important?
A lot of the wildlife that relies on reed bed is really struggling. So nationally, we've lost a lot of our reed bed. It's with intensification of agriculture. So we want to put reed bed back into the landscape to boost the very small populations of reed bed wildlife that we still have. Things like grass snakes to lots of different bird species nest there, warblers, bearded tits, otters.
Half of the lake is open to the public, but the other half is a nature refuge where wildlife can live undisturbed. 160 species of birds have already been recorded.
How many people do you have working here?
We've got over 100 volunteers that help here at Bodnam Lake. So is getting involved in this project something you might be interested in? Because we're always looking for new volunteers.
Absolutely.
And there's no time like the present. Joan is a volunteer who's got a big task on her hands.
This is our reed bed. We only planted them last year. As you can see, they've now grown quite tall, but we've got problems with willows that are beginning to take over. So now they're small. We have to pull them up and weed them because before we know it, they grow so tall that they take out all the light from the reeds, and plus their roots travel along and kill off the reeds.
Can we have a go?
Yes, just join me.
Great.
And they're quite easy to pull up.
So how many do you think you've pulled up since you've been working here?
Well, throughout the summer, I think thousands, maybe millions by now.
Yeah. But they keep coming back.
Yeah, they keep coming back because when willows seed, they're just like dandelions.
Tiny.
And very tiny, and they just spread everywhere.
On the wind?
On the wind, yes.
Right.
Oh, there's a whole crop of little ones here.
Is there a forfeit if you break one without getting the root?
Oh, yes, yes, you have to come back again.
That wouldn't be such a hardship, would it?
Well, you've certainly got your work cut out here, Joan. I'm glad we were able to help out a bit today.
Yes, well, thank you very much.
Well, we'll come back and give you a hand when we've moved here.
Yes, we'll look forward to seeing you.
Well, there are no weeds in our property offerings as we get back to our Herefordshire house hunt. Next stop on our journey is the hamlet of Broadoak, close to the Welsh border. It's surrounded by far-reaching 360-degree views with a smattering of attractive properties on its narrow lanes. A small store in the local garage stocks the basics and caters for all, whether two-legged or four. Half a mile away from the action, we find the next house in our lineup.
Well, chaps, some lovely sunshine to greet our arrival at property number two. What do you think?
Looks fantastic.
This really is more lovely. Like it.
More like it, more rural?
Much more like it.
Far-reaching views, as you can see. You can probably just about make out the tops of the Malvern Hills through there. It's a really lovely elevated position. The property, this is really interesting, actually. It dates back to 1789. However, there is a twist in the tale because 26 years ago, the current owners decided that the house as was too close to the road, took it apart stone by stone, reimagined it and moved it.
Goodness me.
To its current position.
It must have been very close to the road.
Yeah, quite. I mean, it hasn't gained that much, but it has set it off rather nicely.
Yeah.
All right, shall we go and have a look?
Great, yes.
Follow me. Here we go.
This stone-built country house may date back to the early 18th century, but its more recent rebuild means it's in fantastic decorative order and still has more than one foot in the past.
Wow. I guarantee this is not what you were probably expecting. Come on in, let's start with the living room. There you are.
Goodness me.
A reimagined period property.
Wow. This is 26 years old?
Yep.
It feels older, but full of light.
But what I love about it is the way they've incorporated so many of the original elements from the 1789 build, not least what's in this wall over here in the dining room. Have a look at this. This is crazy. They've put in one of the roof trusses into the end of the dining room.
Oh, my goodness. It works really well.
Doesn't it?
What a lovely dining room.
Yeah, it's a great room.
But it all leads through to the kitchen, which is through here.
It's got a lovely warm feel, hasn't it? And it's certainly big enough to entertain in here.
And you've got a lovely conservatory out there, which makes the best use of the views, as you might expect. As we did before, I'm going to give you the run of the first floor, I think, to explore the four bedrooms that are up there. And while you're having a nosy, I'm going to try and find a few more quirky features, because there are plenty of them, I'm sure. Go on, after you.
Thanks.
Upstairs, off a large landing, there's a big and bright family bathroom with feature beams above the bath.
I've always wanted a big bathroom, and maybe it's my time.
A spare bedroom has breathtaking views.
Oh, this is a great size.
For a guest bedroom, it's huge.
Yes, for favourite guests. We could put them in here.
Yeah.
There are also two smaller rooms. And then the master, which has an ensuite shower room.
Oh, this is a nice, light, bright room.
Oh, wow.
Oh, look, and there's a...
dressing room?
Yes.
And very nice and quiet.
Isn't it peaceful? Yes. Which is, I think, what we were looking for, that kind of very peaceful environment.
Well, from where I'm standing, I'd say this remodeled 18th century house is selling itself to both of them.
So how was that?
Great, really interesting.
Yes, whistle-stop tour of upstairs.
Lots of space.
And lots of potential.
Yes, lots we could do, but some of it we love as it is.
Perfect. Right then, let's go outside.
The property sits in a plot of over a quarter of an acre, and the lawn wraps around the house at the back, side and front. There's a stone garage, and the attractive conservatory leads to a generous-sized patio, well suited to alfresco dining and taking in the extensive views.
In fairness, probably not quite as much space as you had with property one. However, the bonus is that you get all of that to look at, which is just stunning.
It is a view, but it isn't very big.
But it does give you the option to stargaze.
Yeah, I think this would do very well. There's not going to be much in the way of light pollution. We've got a lovely big horizon for 180 degrees.
Yeah.
And, you know, unless we go and live on the top of a mountain, it's going to be hard to do better. Yeah.
Good. Right then. Well, let's now consider what this might be on the market for. Jennifer.
I'm developing a bit of a theme here. I'm going to say 675.
£675,000.
I think this is at the top of our price range, so I would say 690,000.
OK. I know there are a couple of compromises you would probably have to make here, not least the size of the garden, albeit with gorgeous views. So if this were on the market for an asking price of £650,000, maybe that might take the edge off a bit.
That certainly makes a difference. I think it's got lots of potential. There's lots we could do. It would be nice to have some budget.
It's actually a really nice house.
Yes, right, we really like it.
Good. It's yours for as long as you need. It's the end of the day. Take your time.
Thank you.
Come and find you later on.
Thanks very much.
Off you go.
Priced well under budget, leaving £50,000 in the kitty, this 1700s remodeled stone house has rooms of good proportions, including a large kitchen diner and three receptions. There are four bedrooms and wonderful views from the garden.
When we first saw the house, I thought two things. I thought, I really like how quiet it is here, and I really was knocked out by the view. Clear, wonderful view.
I think I felt the same. The look of the house was really nice, and I also really loved the sound, or rather lack of, when we got out of the car, and there was just that peace of the countryside which we are looking for. I would say the only tiny downside is the garden space isn't perhaps quite what we wanted, but the plus side is stargazing. You could really see the sky.
Yeah, there's a fabulous view of the sky. That's true.
It has turned out to be gorgeous, hasn't it?
Isn't it fabulous?
Well, the sun shines on the righteous. So
and
they
the
say.
Unrighteous.
Well, let's hope so. Right then, that's it for today, though, chaps. House tours
Great.
Are done.
Thank you very much.
Time to relax. Come on.
But before we turn in, and as the weather is so lovely, I simply can't resist the chance to share a little of my local knowledge. I hope Graham and Jennifer have saved some energy.
Wow, that is a good climb, isn't it?
It certainly is.
But there's the reward.
What a view.
It's worth it.
Well worth it.
Absolutely stunning.
This is one of my favourite spots in Herefordshire, the top of Garway Hill. So behind us, of course, the Wye Valley. Over there, we've got the Malverns. There, we've got Clee Hill. But that is what is taking my breath away. As the sun sets over the Black Mountains, it is absolutely stunning, isn't it?
It's absolutely fabulous. It's beautiful.
It is. Fantastic spot.
What a treat for the end of the day.
Well, that's
good
what I thought.
To come up here, yeah.
I think seeing all this certainly makes me feel that I want to be here.
Yeah, I think we knew anyway, but this absolutely underlines it. This is a good place to be.
I mean, you've got, what, 50 miles visibility, I would say, in every direction.
Easily.
We should be able to find somewhere in there.
I would think so.
I just know that out there somewhere is the home for me, and I hope for Graham too.
We're in Herefordshire on the second leg of our hunt for a home in the countryside to suit Jennifer and Graham from Faversham in Kent. Still to come, we've got a huge surprise in store with our mystery house.
Oh!
And I get to tuck into a crunchy taste of the county.
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
Our couple are lucky enough to have £700,000 to play with, but Herefordshire has lots of property gems to suit budgets of all sizes. This red brick detached house has two bedrooms, sits up high in the hamlet of Portway, and delivers great views. It's on the market for just under £230,000. If you fancy trying out the area before digging too deep into your pockets, this could be just the place to do it. With three double bedrooms and manicured gardens, the rent on this barn conversion is £1,000 a month. Or for a mini break, you could hide away in this quirky one-bedroom cottage with its cosy interior and a working 1900s clock in the tower above the bed. It's in the village of Colwall and costs just under £600 for a three-night weekend in peak season.
Well, we have one more day of house hunting to go and one more property to see. Now, I think you'll agree that Herefordshire is not short on beautiful landscapes or indeed beautiful spots within it. However, there is one corner of this county that I've not yet visited with Graham and Jennifer in tow. However, it is one of my favourite haunts and it also happens to be where our mystery house is.
The final journey on our Herefordshire house hunt takes us to the hamlet of the Beige. It's situated in the Golden Valley, which lies between the Wye Valley and the border with Wales. There's a real buzz in the air just 5 miles away in the cultural town of Hay-on-Wye, home to the world-famous literary festival. We're all familiar with the town, but there's so much to see and do here that I never pass up an opportunity to stop by.
Well, I thought before we get to our mystery house, we would pause here in Hay-on-Wye. I think it's a really, really lovely thing to have on your doorstep, which it would be if you like our mystery house, because that is only 10 minutes away
Ooh,
from here.
Yeah. That's exciting.
It is really exciting.
And the last time we stayed in Hay, it was during the festival, and we spent a couple of nights in a teepee, actually, which was...
Go well?
Yeah, we got through it, but we won't do it again, I think.
Well, you'll be delighted to know that our mystery house will, I hope, keep you a little drier and warmer than a teepee would. But, of course, a great stepping off point if you want to come back to the festival in the future.
That would be nice.
Sounds
right,
great.
Good. Should we go and have a look?
Yes, please.
Come on then.
Back in the Beige, we find our last offering. This fabulous and rather large stone property. But it's at the back where we find out what puts the mystery into our last house.
Right then, we can now broker our final offering of the week, guys, our mystery property with 8 acres.
Oh!
8 acres stretching up there to the larger hedge you can see in the background. Yeah. The boundary is a little brook, come stream, okay, at the bottom of it.
Yeah, and also nice to have running water, a stream or a brook or something like that. That's
with the occasional otter.
Oh, really?
Absolutely. The wildlife here is terrific. And there, at the far end, is the back of our mystery house.
Very mysterious.
The building itself is fascinating. It used to be a pub.
Ah, we'd love to see inside.
Right, let's do it. Come on.
This former pub dates back to around 1800. Its style is typical of the area, built from attractive local stone.
So here's the front of our former inn. Quite imposing, I think.
It's a big house.
Yeah, got three floors to play with.
I love the stone.
Yeah, well, there's plenty more where that came from. There we go. Start with the main event, I suppose, kitchen diner.
It's really bright.
Very nice. Big.
And this enormous conservatory, garden room, garden boot room. I mean, goodness knows what you could do with that.
Yeah.
There's a boot room itself next door. You've got another little utility area with all the washing machines in it out right there and so on.
I like it. I could certainly see getting friends and family around the kitchen table without too much difficulty.
Yeah. Excellent. Right, let's have a look at some more. Come through here. So, no longer full of carousing locals. Our former pub has a much calmer feel now, but I think what they've done here, opening this up, is really lovely. You've got the burner there, of course, dining area, and then very cosy living space here.
That works really quite well, doesn't it?
It's lovely and light as well, with the three big windows.
There are another two stories above us here, which do take a bit of exploring, so that's your cue.
Great.
There's the stairs.
Let's go have a look.
Off you go.
Let's go.
After you.
Along with the open plan reception rooms on the ground floor, there's also a cosy snug and a home office. Then on the first floor, there's both a family bathroom and a shower room to serve three bedrooms, a single and two doubles.
It'd be lovely to wake up in the morning to that view, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't be so bad, would it?
Yes.
I think the thick walls make it quiet, give it a nice peaceful feeling.
I think a house like this would really lend itself to Christmas and family.
Well, it's a pub.
Yeah.
Where else to celebrate Christmas?
Stairs lead to the second floor and one of two further bedrooms up in the eaves of the house.
Overspill accommodation here. And although it's walk through from that double room into this one, I think if you're all family...
I'm thinking of the grandchildren. This is the room, parents and grandchildren.
We haven't got any yet.
I know, but, you know, we've got to be realistic.
Yes.
It's always good to plan ahead, and with a house this size, there are tons of options. Outside, along with the acres and acres of land, there's woodland, a collection of barns, outbuildings and stables. And the property is surrounded by pretty terraced gardens.
Wow. How was that then, exploring the two floors?
Really interesting.
Yeah, it's a really nice big house.
Well, we've talked really about the land when we arrived, so I think pretty much you've got an idea of what the whole package represents. We just need to deal with the issue of what it might cost you.
I'll say 700. I think it's at the top of our, absolutely at the top. It is a really nice house.
All in at £700,000, says your husband, Jennifer.
I'm going to be really brave and say 690.
So this is on the market for £645,000.
Really? With the 8 acres.
And if you don't want all of those 8 acres, the family selling it are farmers here. They will gladly relieve you of what you don't want. That will, of course, be reflected in the final asking price, subject to negotiation.
I think we would want the land, so that's a very, very good price.
Good. Well, look, have a wander around. There's plenty more that you haven't seen. The outbuildings, of course, and, you know, some of the other little nooks and crannies in the building.
Yes.
And I'll come and find you a little bit later on. But I'm really pleased you've enjoyed seeing it. Off you go.
A former 19th century inn, our mystery house has got a lot going for it, and yet is a surprising £55,000 below budget. There's a great farmhouse kitchen diner, numerous reception rooms, 5 bedrooms and outside delivers 8 acres to play with, including an assortment of outbuildings.
Very good. I would keep a lot of firewood in here. Vehicles, machinery, a small boat.
We have really loved the mystery house. It was such a surprise. And the fact that it's got all this land is very exciting.
I think it's probably the closest thing to what I kind of imagined we would, if we were lucky, find. Of course, there's one thing, which is the road. But the house, when you're inside it, is quiet and peaceful. So the road is not a deal breaker, I don't think.
Well, Jennifer Graham, that's it. Our house tours are now complete. It whizzes by, doesn't it?
It certainly does.
Great couple of days.
Excellent. And hopefully ended on a high.
Yes.
It very much has.
Good. Right, come on then. Let's go make sense of it all.
What better to go with our mystery house pub conversion than a pint and a packet of crisps? And on one Herefordshire farm near Ross-on-Wye, two local farmers have come together to create a novel crisp brand. But that's not all. They've come up with a groundbreaking answer to the problem of what to do with the 6 billion bags of crisps sold in the UK each year once the contents have been eaten. Of course, the story begins with the humble potato. And I've come to meet Mark Green and Sean Mason, who head up the business.
So, Sean and Mark, what brought about this initiative to get into crisps?
Sean and I have been friends all our lives, and we all had this dream to turn our own potatoes into crisps.
Trying to get our own potatoes low food miles was one of the big things, so our production is very, very close to where we grow, usually within less than 2 miles. And then looking at flavourings that also come from Herefordshire.
So what is it that makes the perfect crisping potato? Can we dig one up and have a quick
look? We can. They want to be nice and round. They don't want to be too big. And of course, most important is the variety. Now, the variety of potatoes we use, this one particularly, is called Taurus. It'll only crisp, so it won't boil or bake. And hopefully, that's what gives you really, really great tasting crisps.
These are lovely and uniform, aren't they? Covered in this lovely red Herefordian soil.
Mark and Sean turn half a ton of potatoes into 3,000 bags of crisps an hour, and it's here on site that it all happens.
Well, this is a far cry from the field we've just been in, guys. Far more high tech in here, fellas.
They produce 4 different flavours of crisps.
What we wanted our flavours to be about Herefordshire, the beef and cider were 2 products straight away that were very much about Herefordshire.
But it's not all about what's inside the packet. The packaging itself is the star here.
The big change that we wanted was to take packaging to a different level, seeing plastic waste around, not just Herefordshire, the whole of the country. We didn't want to be packing in plastic. And this is 100% compostable.
But what's it made from?
So it's made from the cellulose of wood pulp and a paper outer.
Now then, the smell in here is driving me nuts. This is the sausage and mustard. Yep. Can I try some?
You can.
Well, the proof of the pudding, or the crisp. Oh, wow. Pretty That's good. Amazing. But then the packaging seems to me to be the icing on the cake.
Even the inks on the packet, they're all compostable, they're all vegetable, so they all break down.
Mark and Sean have taken their remarkable efforts running a sustainable brand one step further.
We're already on the farm running an anaerobic digester, and it's running all the energy in the factory here today. So it was great to be able to say that any waste packaging that we got, we take down to the anaerobic digester and it gets composted with all the other materials and then goes into the digester and makes energy.
To say I'm impressed is an understatement. I want to see this beast for myself, and I'm pretty pleased I can ditch the hairnet too.
Well, it certainly smells like a compost heap, lads.
Well, basically, it's a giant cow. And we're producing all this food on the farm and waste, and we bring it here and we put it inside this digester and we make methane gas. The methane gas then taken to an engine, it runs an engine, the engine generates electric, and then we power the homes or the factory. It's a big investment, but when you can produce your own energy for the farm, yeah, out of things that you're producing on the farm, it's a win-win.
Now, in terms of composting, I still can't get over the fact that this can disappear into some nice brown compost. But I can just chuck it in there.
You can put that one into there. That's recently, that's bags recently gone into that compost. And this is some that has been in a few months, and these are bags that are breaking down.
So how long would it take then for my crisp packet to completely disappear?
Well, in an ambient temperature as this is outside, around 26 weeks.
Well, Sean, Mark, thanks for showing us around today. Really fascinating. I'm almost envious, really, of your endeavour. It's such a good idea. And I think the packaging, I think, reminds us all that there is now a sustainable future out there, and we can put it all in our compost heaps, even if they're not quite as big as the one you guys have got. Here's to Herefordshire. Well done.
So there's lots to celebrate in the county. Let's hope our next celebration is a home in the countryside here.
Well, our house search this week with Graham and Jennifer has been an awful lot of fun, but let's not forget, there's a lot of money riding on it. It is, at the end of the day, a very serious business. So we have one more question to ask them. Have we managed to find them a home for the future? And where better to do that than down in my local.
Well, Graham and Jennifer, how are you after this hectic few days of running around Herefordshire?
Well, it's been great fun.
So we've given you three very interesting houses to consider. Have we helped you also perhaps refine the wish list, shall we say, that you first started out with?
Yeah, I think so. For me, one of the things that I had on the wish list was the idea of a big view. Third house really didn't have a view. It was more part of a view. But I like that house better than the other two, much better than the other two.
The mystery house offered a real project. There was so much to get your teeth into there with the land, the gardens, the outbuildings, the house itself. And I think Graham likes nothing better than a good project. We're going to give it some really serious thought.
Well, guys, it's been an awful lot of fun. Do give the mystery house due consideration. But either way, I'm fairly confident that sometime soon we may be back in this pub garden celebrating the fact that you have moved here, hopefully to our mystery house, but who knows, to whatever it is. We wish you all the very best of luck.
Thank you. It's been really great fun. We've loved it.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's been a great couple of days.
Cheers.
Cheers. Yeah.
Here's to meeting again.
Drink to that.
Well, I think it's safe to say that Graham and Jennifer aren't the only buyers in recent years to have fallen in love with this gorgeous county. My own love affair with Herefordshire began over a decade ago, and I can assure you it's as real now as it was then. Its landscape, its history, and its rich property market very rarely fail to deliver, and frankly, it has not let us down this week either. As for our buyers, well, they may go for our mystery house, but I think one thing is for sure, when eventually they do move, it'll be to the glittering hills and valleys of the Golden Valley. I'll see you next time.
If you would like to escape to the country in Wales, England, Scotland or Northern Ireland and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk.
Thank you.